control. But thousands of women across the country, including many in our area, say they have suffered tremendous pain and long-term damage. And here's the catch. The law prevents those women from suing the company that makes that device.
Investigative reporter Paul Van Osdahl live tonight with that story. Paul.
Well, Andrew, Wendy, the device is called Esure, and it's touted as a safe alternative to tubal ligation, otherwise known as tube tying. After extensive testing, the FDA said Esure was safe and even put it in a class that exempts manufacturers, in this case Bayer, from lawsuits. Now, the environmental activist Aaron Brockovich is taking on the company and the law on behalf of women who say they are suffering. After Beth Shoup had her second child in just 2 years, she decided to get sterilized. Her doctor recommended Esure.
She does 1 to 2 recovery day, and boom, you're good to go.
So it must have sounded good.
Yeah, it did. It sounded really good.
Here's how Esure works. The doctor inserts coils into a woman's fallopian tubes. Then the body forms a natural barrier around the coils that prevents sperm from reaching the eggs. It's non-invasive and supposedly pain-free. But from the moment she came out of surgery, Beth was in tremendous pain.
I mean, I was crying because I was in so much pain, and my legs hurt, they were cramping.
It only got worse. So bad, she could not even care for her two young children.
I had to use a walker because I couldn't walk on my own. If I had to hold on to something because the back pain and the pelvic pain was so bad.
Her doctors could not figure out what was causing the problem. Eventually, the doctor who inserted the coils removed them and did a tubal ligation. Almost immediately, Beth says her health improved. Later, she filed a complaint with the FDA. FDA records show that in just the past 5 years, 698 women have filed complaints about Esure. Most women have complained about painful side effects, but some have said they got pregnant even after getting the procedure. Beth also found a Facebook page and a website where thousands of women who had the Esure procedure described symptoms similar to hers.
Ovarian cysts, back pain, pelvic pain, sharp stabbing pain, bladder problems.
Including Patricia Knuckles of Charleroi.
Fatigue, loss of energy, headaches, migraines, irregular periods, painful periods.
What's it like to live with all this?
Honestly, it's day by day, it's very difficult.
It's been hard, you know, seeing her sick a lot, and, you know, hunched over in pain a lot.
Dr. John Fish has done hundreds of Esure procedures, and he says he has had very few complaints. But with 750,000 women getting the coils during the past decade, he's not surprised there are complications.
Sure, there are people who do not do well with the procedure, but all in all, for the majority of patients, it's a very safe and effective procedure.
Bayer, whose North American headquarters is in Robinson Township, also defends Esure. The company sent a statement that says, in part, Esure has a well-documented benefit-risk profile with over 400 peer-reviewed publications and abstracts supporting its safety, efficacy, and cost-effectiveness. But with thousands of women complaining, activist Aaron Brockovich says the company needs to do more. She says so many of those women contacted her that she began a campaign against Esure.
Hear these women, and if necessary, you know, take your product off the market, take a look at it, and make sure it is safe before you put it back out there.
She is also pushing Congress to repeal the law that gives Esure and other medical devices special protection, making them immune from lawsuits. Now, that law is aimed at encouraging companies to sell devices that could get them sued. The FDA does additional testing on these products before they can be sold, and in exchange for those delays, companies get the lawsuit exemption. Now, weeks ago, I tried contacting the FDA about all this, but they did not respond. Finally, I heard from them last week, and a spokesman said they could not comment because of the government shutdown. But they say they will have something to say when the government reopens.
Which might be tonight.
Which could be soon. Yeah.
All right. So
hopefully we'll have an update.
Good. Paul, thank you very much.
Okay.
Wow.